puzzle in between. Because what takes you from where you wanted to go and thought you couldn't make it, and where you are and think, well, you settled, you didn't. Because sooner or later, when you train that muscle in between, you make life work on both sides. Whatever you are here makes this work here. Your dreams never die. You might become a millionaire over here. And that opera that you wanted to be, or that griffin that you wanted to be here, that technology that you wanted to be, you will wind up facilitating it. It will wind up making you better who you are. So who you are, wherever you are, I discovered, make it wonderful. Make it wonderful. I've worked in an office. Can't do anything, but I went into an office as a file clerk, because that's all I could do. When my son was born, I wanted to be with my son, and so I couldn't go out traveling, and I decided to give my son 5 to 6 years before I ever did anything else. So I went and found a job in a big company as a file clerk, which is about the lowest paid job in office work. It was two companies with offices in between, building on this side, building on that. I'm from Chicago, so it's called Goldenrod Ice Cream Company and Humiston & Keeley Wholesale Druggist, owned by two brothers. The two brothers, one was president of one side, and one was president of the people that made everything run was in the middle. You walk through to one side to the other. Each brother was totally qualified for what they were doing. The problem they had, that break in the middle, was where I was. I came in, young woman, 1920. And the place, both sides were suffering from a break from the other. And I looked. And I found out what was wrong. The filing system. Nobody could find what they want. Everything was in the one filing system. One side would come, and there were many departments, and get a file, and maybe bring it back and forget to bring it back. While the other side would need that file, come to find it, couldn't find it. And so everything stopped until the file clerk went right around like a chicken with a head cut off and found the file. And that's how it had gone on. And this was two successful companies. Only they couldn't keep a file clerk. I figured the file clerk was someplace to go. The last one to go. And so I came in to work with no credentials, even in file clerk. But it turned out the man who hired me, who was over, interviewed me and said, well, so where are you from? And I said, well, here in Chicago. And he said, and I said, well, actually, I wasn't born in Chicago. I was born in Robbins, Illinois. He said, really? I'm from Midlothian, which is about 5 blocks or a mile away from each other. And I said, really? So I never got an interview about what I could do for them. We talked about them. He said, well, who were you doing? I said, well, my father was magistrate and then mayor of the town. He said, who's your father? I said, Samuel Nichols. He said, he brought the water in from downtown. We had no water. We had had to go pump the water. When he became mayor, he, who wasn't a politician, he was a kid. He worked downtown Chicago and had connections. And that's how, and he told me about his ancestors. I knew my father and looked up to him because he was, yeah. You see how it works? So that's actually how I got the job. I didn't know what a file clerk was. I didn't know what they filed. And the next thing I knew, I so appreciated that because I wanted to stay in Chicago. And I did not want to, I was determined not to be away from my son, my baby, and to give him my all. So I had nothing to do except to figure out how to pull these two people, because those are driving me crazy. I'm not going to go running around. I'm Michelle Nichols. I'm a ballerina, an entertainer. I'm a great actress. I'm a singer. I'm not running around this place looking for a file that should have been in. And that's what I was expected to do. So I decided who these people were on this side and who these people were on that side. So what do you think I did? I made 2 files. One for that side and one for the other. Put them all together and they had to come in, and then I made some stickers that went in. And then you could not take a file out without putting a card in there. The date, your initials, and your office and where it is. Wow, things started humming. Both sides. That's what life is. Making both sides work. Remember when Congress used to work that way? I think it was called what? Bipartisanship. What an idea. Whatever happened to working together? So I took my two voice discovery and I put it in, and the place started humming. Until somebody decided to say, no, you go and get it, and so forth. And so I locked the room. They couldn't get into it until the chief, which I, by this time, elevated myself to the chief communications officer. No. The chief file clerk. And my boss, I went to him, and he raised my title to chief file clerk. There weren't any other file clerks. Chief file clerk. And you couldn't get